walking through the forest one day. It was late September, no, early May. I came upon an old man sitting by the trail. His hair was gray, his face was pale, and he said, "Son, it's getting dark, and this fire's warm. Would you care to sit down?" "All right." He asked me if I would like some wine. I said, "All right." He started to pour. "Yes, enough." I said, "Fine." Then he looked at me with tears in his eyes. His face seemed familiar under the beard and the lines. I felt scared. It seemed so strange. Something's wrong. But what? I told him, "You look so familiar. I know I've seen you. Where I can place it right now." He smiled and said, "Don't worry, it'll come, son." He looked at me. "Oh wait, this can't be. You're me. About the rest of my life, how in a year I would marry, live in a cottage with my wife. But if it's already happened, what becomes of me now?" He began to speak, sounding sorry somehow. He said, "Son, you're not real. You're just a memory that I love a great deal. I'll show you I'm real enough, sir." So I ran through the woods as fast as I could for miles and miles and miles far away. I'm sure he won't find me, but now where will I stay? I see a house. The lantern's on. Someone's home. I ran and knocked. A kind old woman opened the door. She asked why I knocked. Story, she led me inside. She said, "Well, while you're here, won't you look in the mirror?" So I looked into the looking glass, and there he was, and we were as one. Suddenly I saw in my mind all the memories that made up the rest of my life. I know this is my house that I built in the forest for you, my wife, my loving wife.